Hello viewers, this is your Ranjana ma'am and you're watching, yes, it's your channel as well as my channel, and this time it is for my ISE students, Act 3, Scene 2 of the Tempest. Many of you have been waiting, and I know, for your class 11 syllabus, class 11 boards, 10th Feb, you need Act 3. So I have done Act 3, Scene 1, and this is Act 3, Scene 2. This is a subplot. In Act 3, Scene 2, as you have found earlier also, you will find Trinculo, Caliban and Stephano, the minor characters. The subplots were introduced to give comic relief to the audience and also to help the major artists or players to take some rest. This was the plan, that is why the subplots were used. They came at intervals to give the major characters some rest. Remember, they were staged. They were put on the stage. So, Caliban, Stephano and Trinculo, you have already seen how Caliban has fallen for this Stephano, because he has not seen anyone else other than Prospero, and to him Prospero is like a dictator. Why? Because he treats him very strictly. So he feels that in Stephano he'll find a better master, and he also feels he can get rid of Prospero. So Sycorax's son, what more can you expect from him? He is suggesting different methods to Stephano to go and kill Prospero and become the lord of this island. Enter Caliban, Stephano and Trinculo. Stephano, tell not me, when the butt is out, we will drink water, not a drop before. Therefore, bear up and board them. Servant monster, drink to me. So Stephano is actually a very type of servant. He's like, if I'm not mistaken, he is the butler, the king's butler, and Trinculo is the jester. So both of them are quite low. But here Caliban has raised them to the high post because he has not seen anyone better. And Prospero, though, he will never accept. Mane, he is really angry with Prospero because Prospero treats him badly. So he thinks that Stephano has the power. Why? Because he has given him a taste of his liquor. So he feels this must be a heavenly drink. And since this man has it, he might be a very powerful man. So he is ready to exchange masters. And Stephano is naturally very flattered, because up till now he was a servant of the king, and now he is having a servant for himself. So Stephano is also drunk. So he's telling, don't tell me, don't mention me. When the cask of wine, which cask of wine? The royal wine which was in the ship. Remember when he had jumped into the waters to save his life from the shipwreck. He had also taken this cask of wine along with him, and he is hid it in one cave of the island. So he says, until all the royal wine is exhausted, I will not drink water. So long as it is there, I will not drink water. Only when it is exhausted, I will drink water, but not before that. So he is telling Caliban, so come and let's start drinking again. And then he tells Caliban, he's already accepted Caliban as his servant. And he starts telling that servant monster, drink to my health. So Trinculo, he feels, oh, this fellow, this stupid fellow has made Stephano a master. So naturally he is feeling a bit jealous. And he says, servant monster, the folly of this island. They say there is but five upon this isle. We are three of them. If the other two be brain like us, the state totters. So Trinculo says, oh, just see Stephano, he started calling Caliban the servant monster. Okay, so a lot of folly is taking place here. So we have been told that there are five people on this island. Yes, these three, Ferdinand, these three and Miranda and Prospero. Caliban knows up till this. So there are only 5 people in this island, so we are 3 of them. The other 2, if they are just like us, then the state is in a shaky condition. Stephano, drink, servant monster, when I bid thee. So when I order you, drink. Thy eyes are almost set in thy head. So your eyes are almost fixed in your head and coming out, staring. So Trinculo, at every talk, na, he is interfering and poking his nose. So just see, where should they be else set else? He were a brave monster indeed if they were set in his tail. So all of them are drunk also. So Trinculo is telling, then if his eyes are not set in his head, where should it be set? And he would be a really very remarkable monster if the eyes were set in his tail. How can you think of any creature with the eyes set in the tail? So Stephano, my man monster had drowned his tongue in sap. For my part, the sea cannot drown me. I swam ere I could recover the shore 35 leagues off and on. By this lie, you shalt be my lieutenant monster or my standard. So he is going very high on drinks. So he is telling Caliban that Caliban is soaked or steeped in wine. Rather, Stephano is more because he has been drinking from a long time, drinking for quite some time, much before Caliban had come. Before that only he had been drinking. So he is telling, my man monster is very drunk, but as for myself, even the sea cannot drown me. Why? Because I have swum 35 means 35 leagues before I could reach the shore. So I have completed 35 leagues. That means the ship was 35 leagues distant from the shore. So I have swum that distance to reach the shore. And then he tells Caliban that you will be my lieutenant or standard bearer, the flag bearer. Trinculo, your lieutenant, if you list, he is no standard. So if you please, he can rather be your lieutenant, but he cannot be your standard bearer because he has no standard. Stephano, we'll not run, Moshe monster. So we shall not run away from our enemies, Mr. Monster. Moshe is a French term used for Mr. or Sir, and Mademoiselle or Mademoiselle for the female. We use this term. So he's telling, Moshe monster, we are not going to run away from our enemies. Means we'll be brave enough to face them. Nor go neither, but you lie like dogs and yet say nothing neither. So Trinculo keeps on poking and troubling them. So he says, no, you will not run. You will not walk also. So he says that we'll not run means we'll face them bravely. And he is taking it deliberately in the other sense and saying, yes, what running? You won't be able to walk. You will be lying on the ground like dogs and keep dumb when you are faced. You are before your enemies. Munka, speak once in thy life if thou beest good Munka. So monster, if you are a really good monster, at least speak. Caliban had been, stupefied by the drink. So finally he has found his voice and he says, how does thy honor? Let me lick thy shoe. I'll not serve him. He is not valiant. So he is eager to serve Stephano, who has provided him with a drink. And he is not ready to serve Trinculo. Why? Because he says he is not brave. So I am not going to serve him. He is not brave. I am ready to lick your shoes. So Trinculo has got very angry because he thinks that Stephano is hardly any, master. He can never be a master. And this man is projecting him as something, this monster is projecting him as something high and mighty. So he is getting a bit jealous. So he's telling, thou liest, most ignorant monster, I am in case to jostle a constable. Why, thou debauched fish? Thou, was there ever man a coward that had drunk so much sack as I today? Wilt thou tell a monstrous lie, being but half a fish and half a monster? So Trinculo is also drunk, I said. So he is scolding Caliban and telling, you stupid monster, you are telling a lie. I am strong enough to fight and push a constable. And you are a drunken fish. Can a man who has drunk so much wine as I have done today, can such a man be a coward? Oh, so being brave depends upon how much wine you have taken in. So he is saying that I have taken in so much drink, so how can I be a coward? How can you tell such a big lie? Being only half a fish and half a human being. Half a human being or half a monster, he says. We were told that Caliban is half fish, half human. And he tells you're half fish and you're half monster. Lo, how he mocks me. Will thou let him, my lord? So like children complain to their mothers. The pama, he is teasing me. So like this, he is complaining to Stephano. Just see how he is making fun of me. Will you allow that to happen? Lord, quoth he, that a monster should be such a natural. So Trinculo goes on teasing. So he says, oh my God, he calls Stephano a lord. Oh my God, how can a monster be such a natural fool? Stephano, Caliban, lo, lo, again, bite him to death, I pray thee. So again, he's complaining. Just see, he's again making fun of me. My lord, please bite him. Stephano, Trinculo, keep a good tongue in your head. If you prove a mutineer, the next tree. The poor monster's my subject, and he shall not suffer indignity. So Stephano, like a true master, he's telling Trinculo, behave yourself. If you are rebellious, then I will hang you in the next tree. So there was a time when the mutineers or the rebel people, their punishment was to be hung on a tree. So if you prove to be a rebellious person, if you prove to be a mutineer, then I will hang you in the next tree. You will be hung on the next tree. So this poor monster is my subject and I will not allow that he should be treated in a contemptuous manner. I thank my noble lord. Will thou be pleased to hearken once again to the suit I made to thee? So my lord, I thank you for taking my side and supporting me. Now will you listen to the proposal which I had made to you? Hearken means old. It's an old English for hear. Stephano, marry, will I. Kneel and repeat it. I will stand and so shall Trinculo. So marry actually means in faith or by marry. It doesn't mean to get married. I always say this. So, yes, in faith I shall listen. You go down on your knees and put your appeal before me. I will stand here and so will Trinculo and we shall listen to your proposal. So now Ariel had been told by Prospero to keep a watch on these creatures. So Ariel comes here. He is invisible. As I told thee before, I am a subject to a tyrant. A sorcerer that by his cunning had cheated me of this island. So Caliban is telling Stephano that I have already told you before that I am a slave to an oppressor, a tyrant. And he is a magician who has taken away this island from me with his cunning means. Ariel. So he goes and speaks in Trinculo's ears. Trinculo's voice. He imitates Trinculo's voice so that these two will think that it is Trinculo speaking while he is not. So he says, thou liest. Caliban, thou liest, thou jesting monkey, thou, I would my valiant master would destroy thee. I do not lie. So he is telling, oh, you are saying that I am lying. You fool, you jesting monkey. So he's very angry. He says, I just wish that my master should kill you. I do not lie. I am not telling a lie. So, Stephano, Trinculo, if you trouble him any more in his tail by this hand, I will supplant some of your teeth. So, Stephano gives a warning. Trinculo, I'm telling you, if you trouble him any more, with this hand, I will knock out some of your teeth. So, Trinculo feels, oh my God, this time I didn't say anything. So, he says, why? I said nothing. Stephano, mum, then, and no more. Proceed. So, he says, then keep silent and don't talk. And then he tells Caliban, you proceed. I say, by sorcery he got this isle. From me he got it. If thy greatness will revenge it on him, for I know thou darest, but this thing dare not. So, he is telling that this tyrant has got this island from me with his magic. So, if you will, if your lordship will punish him, it will be a good revenge. And I know that you can do it. You dare do it, but this one cannot. Trinculo. Stephano, that's most certain. That's most certain that I can do it. Caliban, thou shalt be lord of it and I'll serve thee. You will be lord of this island after killing that man, and I will be your servant. How now shall this be compassed? Canst thou bring me to the party? So, how will this take place? How will this be done? Will you take me to where the party is? That means where Prospero is. Yea, my lord, I'll yield him thee asleep. Yes, my lord. I will take you to him when he is asleep. I will hand him over to you when he is asleep. Why? He knows when Prospero is alive, he is at his most potent. He is most powerful then. Where thou mayest knock a nail into his head. Yeah, I'll take you to him when he is asleep. And you might take a nail and put it in his head. Means you might strike him with a nail right through his head. Thou liest, thou canst not. Who's saying this? Ariel. And in whose voice? Trinculo's voice. So that they think it is Trinculo speaking. What a pied ninny is this, thou scurvy patch? I do beseech thy greatness. Give him blows and take his bottle from him. When that's gone, he shall drink naught but brine. For I'll not show him where the quick freshers are. So Caliban has become very irritated, very angry, very frustrated. So, he's telling, what type of fool are you? Actually, he has the dress, colored dress, partly colored dress. So, in this, that is Trinculo's garment. So, he's telling that you scurvy patch, you mean fool. And then he tells Stephano, I request your lordship, hit him, take away his bottle from him. And when he doesn't have anything to drink, he will have no other option but to drink the salty waters of the sea, because I will not show him where the fresh springs of this island are. Stephano, Trinculo, run into no further danger. Interrupt the monster one word further, and by this hand I'll turn my mercy out of doors and make a stockfish of thee. So, Stephano again scolds Trinculo. He says that, don't make me angry anymore. Don't invite danger. If you interrupt this monster again, then with this hand, I will forget all mercy, and with this hand beat you in the same manner as a codfish, dried codfish is beaten up before it is put to boil. So, I will also beat you in that manner. Trinculo, puzzled. Why? What did I? I did nothing. I'll go further off. Oh my God, I did nothing. So, I'll go and stand far away. Didst thou not say he lied? Ariel again, deliberately. Thou liest. In Trinculo's voice. Do I so? Take thou that. So, you are telling me that I am also lying. So, then take this. So, he hits. As you like this, give me the lie another time. So, this is for you. And he now beats Trinculo and he says, if you like to be beaten up again, then tell I am lying. Contradict me again. If you like this beating, then ask for it. Just tell that I have lied again and I will give you a nice beating. Trinculo, I did not give thee the lie. I never say you lied. Out of your wits and hearing too. So have you run out of your senses and your hearing capacity also? Hearing power. Have you lost your hearing as well as your senses? A pox on your bottle. So may a curse fall on your bottle. This can sack and drinking do. So this is the result of your drinking so much wine. A murrain on your monster and the devil take your fingers. So may a plague fall on your monster and may the devil crush your fingers. Why? For hitting me. So he's cursing both Caliban and Stephano. Caliban is very amused that Trinculo has got beaten up. Ha ha ha. Stephano, now forward with your tale. So you proceed with your tale. And prithee, stand further up. This is an instruction to Trinculo. You stand further up and you proceed with your tale. Caliban beat him enough. And after a little time, I'll beat him too. Yeah. So when he gets less powerful, then I will also beat him. At this moment, he dare not beat. Stephano, stand further to Caliban. Come, proceed. So one instruction for Trinculo, another for Caliban. Caliban, why? As I told thee, it is a custom with him in the afternoon to sleep. So as I told you, it is his habit to sleep in the afternoon. There thou mayest brain him, having first seized his books. So there you can dash out his brains. And when? After you have seized his books. Because Caliban knows that the books are the main source of Prospero's power. So first, take control of his books when he is asleep. And then go and dash out his brains. Or with a log, batter his skull. So the different ways to murder Prospero is being suggested by Caliban. So you can take a piece of log and break his skull. Or punch him with a stake. Or you can also rip open his stomach with a stake. Or cut his weasand with thy knife. Or with your knife cut his windpipe. Remember, first to possess his books. Remember, first to take control over his books. Of without them, he is but a sot as I am. Because without his books, he is just ordinary and foolish as I am. With his books, he is so powerful. But without his books, he is as powerless as I am, as foolish as I am. Nor hath not one spirit to command. And without his books, he wouldn't have any spirits to command. They all do hate him as rootedly as I. Yeah, all the spirits also who work for him, they also hate him in the same way as I hate him. Burn but his books. He has brave utensils, so he calls them, which when he has a house, he'll deck with all. So he says that burn his books. So he calls them fine utensils, and when he has a house, he intends to decorate his house with them. And that most deeply to consider is the beauty of his daughter. The thing which is of foremost importance is the beauty of his daughter. He himself calls her a nonpareil. That means Prospero himself says that his daughter is unequaled in beauty. I never saw a woman but only Sycorax, my dam and she. And she as far surpasseth Sycorax as greatest does least. So he says that I've never seen a woman other than Miranda and Sycorax, my mother. But if these two were to be compared, if she is the greatest, my mother is the least. Is it so brave a lass? Is it such a beautiful lady? Hey Lord, she will, monster, I will kill this man, his daughter, and I will be king and queen, save our graces. And Trinculo and thyself shall be viceroys. Dost thou like the plot, Trinculo? So, Stephano is very charged up. He feels, is she such a beautiful lady? So monster, I'll go and kill this man and I and his daughter, we will become the king and the queen, and you and Trinculo, you both will be my viceroys. Then whom will they rule? If they kill Prospero, there will be four people, one the king, other the queen, and the two other viceroys. So over whom will they rule? And he is asking Trinculo if he likes the plot. Trinculo, excellent. Give me thy hand. I am sorry, I beg thee. But while thou livest, keep a good tongue in thy head. So Stephano feels sorry that he has beaten. So he says, let me hold your hand. I am sorry I have beaten you. But keep your tongue under control so long as you are alive. Within this half hour will he be asleep. Wilt thou destroy him then? So within half an hour he'll fall asleep. Will you kill him then? Ay, on mine honor. So he gives him a word of honor. This will I tell my master. Ariel has been listening to everything. So he says, I'll go and report it to Prospero. Caliban, thou makest me merry. I'm full of pleasure. Let us be jocund. Will you troll the catch you taught me but while ere? So Caliban feels that my freedom is coming fast. Why? Freedom from, he feels, the oppression of Prospero. Soon I'll be a free person. So he's very happy. So he says that you have made me very happy. I'm full of pleasure. So let us be merry. And then he asks Stephano that will you sing to me that tune which you had taught me? At thy request, monster, I will do reason, any reason. So, yes, Stephano says, at your request, I will do anything which is reasonable. Come, Trinculo, let us sing. Now they'll sing some rubbish. Flout them and scout them and scout them and flout them. Thought is free. So, Caliban says, that's not the tune. No, no, this is not the song I was asking you. So, actually, the tune had been played by Ariel. Caliban did not know this. He thought that it was Stephano. So Ariel plays the tune on a tabor and a pipe. What is this saying? So what is this what is this tune that we hear? Because we are not singing. Then who is playing this? This is the tune of our catch played by the picture of nobody. So this is the tune of our song. But it is being played by someone invisible. If thou beest a man, show thyself in thy likeness. If thou beest a devil, take it as thou list. So if you are a man, come in your true shape before me. And if you are a devil, you are free to come in any shape you please. Trinculo, oh forgive me my sins. So Trinculo feels, oh my God, if this is a devil, so God please forgive me my sins. He that dies pays all debts. I defy thee. Mercy upon us. So he who dies suffers the worst that can happen to him. I am not afraid of you. May God's mercy protect us. Caliban, art thou afeared? Are you afraid? No monster, not I. Caliban, be not afeared. This isle is full of noises, so don't be afraid. This island is full of all these mysterious sounds. Sweet airs that give delight and hurt not. So these mysterious sounds are delightful to the ears. They don't hurt. Sometimes a thousand twangling instruments will hum about mine ears. So many times it has happened that a number of stringed instruments would be heard as music piercing my ears. And sometimes voices that if I had then waked after long sleep would make me sleep again. So sometimes I would hear such unearthly voices that if I had waken up from sleep, it would make me fall asleep again. It would lull me to sleep. Mane, such a soothing music that it would make me fall asleep. And then in dreaming, the clouds, methought, would open and show riches ready to drop upon me. And then that when I waked, I cried to dream again. And many times I would dream that the clouds would open and show its treasures ready as if to drop upon me. So when I woke up, I longed to go back to sleep again. This will prove a brave kingdom to me, where I shall have my music for nothing. So he is very happy. I don't need a paid musician. I will have my music free. Stephano says, when Prospero is destroyed, Caliban, he's acting quite smart. He's telling, yes, you will be master only when you kill Prospero. That shall be by and by. I remember the story. Yeah, that will happen in time. I remember the story. Trinculo, the sound is going away. Let's follow it and after do our work. So the news is getting far, music is getting far away from us. So let's follow it and then carry out our plans. Trinculo, wilt come? I'll follow Stephano. So he's asking Caliban, will you come? I'm going to follow Stephano. So this is where our act 3 scene 2 ends. This is a simple and easy scene and I don't think you will have any problems. They are plotting something mischievous, and you, if you have read the whole story just as a pastime, you'll realize what treatment awaits them or how they really fall into trouble for planning all this mischief. So that is very funny. No, and I'm not going to break the suspense for those who have not read it. Let it be done by and by. And one more scene remains for my class 11. So one more scene remains for my class 11. They have their full act 3. And class 12, don't be disheartened. I'll try to finish, but you all have your exams a few days later, maybe 2 weeks later. By that time, I'll be free because all my students will, schools, those who are in the junior classes 8, 9, they will already will have finished their exams when you start. Or if not, at least the English paper done. So I will have a lot of time in my hands to continue with the rest. So Ranjana ma'am bids you goodbye. Don't forget to press the like button. Have a good time and let me wish you best of luck. And I'll be waiting for the comments and also to reply to them.